basically, as a pro-democracy lawmaker, together with my colleagues, we've done everything we can, I believe, both within and outside the council. Within, we've tried to stop the process. We ask the tough questions to alert the public to the administration's lies over this bill. Outside of council, I myself have done a lot of traveling to the United States, to Europe, to tell people, foreign governments, about what's happening in Hong Kong.
Perhaps people in the Western democracies, they are used to the idea of separation of powers. But in Hong Kong, our process is slightly different. It would be for the government to formulate a policy. Now, with the current law right now, in addition to trying to get public support, the government, all they needed to do is to count in the legislature. There are 70 seats in the legislature. Then they counted that as long as they get 35 of them. And we know that they do have 35 of them.
I think this time, the government made a real mistake. Because this time, the issue was very close, was even closer to people. Because this issue was really about, do you, as a Hong Kong person, trust the mainland legal system? And do you, as a Hong Kong person, trust being sent to the mainland for trial? And we can see that the answer is a clear no.
What's next is, I think, we need to protect the students who have been arrested. I can reassure you there will be teams of lawyers lining up to defend these students in courts on a pro bono basis if necessary. I think the government will not dare to take the bill back to LegCo in the foreseeable future, but of course never say never. And the price of freedom is constant vigilance. So the Hong Kong people knows that. And I think the world now looks on Hong Kong people again with pride, I think with confidence that the Hong Kong's people's aspiration to freedom and democracy and rule of law will not die.